वेलकम ऑल, माय नेम इज राज बर्गे, आई एम को फाउंडर डायरेक्टर ऑफ राज कंप्यूटर एजुकेशन। पर्पस ऑफ दिस साइट इज टू प्रोवाइड स्टूडेंट्स एजुकेशन इन फील्ड ऑफ आईटी, सो दे कैन गेट प्लेस डायरेक्टली इनटू इंडस्ट्री, दे कैन गेट जॉब्स एंड गेट प्लेसमेंट। थैंक यू। प्लीज लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल टू एवरीवन हु इज इंटरेस्टेड टू गेटिंग जॉब इन आईटी। वी आर हेल्पिंग देम एंड वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग फ्री प्लेसमेंट्स फॉर देम। थैंक यू। Now, what we are going to today cover? We are going to today cover. This was the first. This is the third lecture. Now, what today we are going to understand? We are going to understand some basic default settings of your Bootstrap. I'm saying Bootstrap 4. So, what it is going to say? It is saying when I say font size, it is having by default font size of what? 16 pixels. So, when it comes to line height, it is predefined. It's 1.5. When you say font family, by default it is using Helvetica. This is very good font, and that way it's Helvetica, Helvetica, Arial, and so on. Now, very important thing regarding paragraph, by default your paragraph top margin is 0, your bottom margin is 1 rim, which is equal to 16 pixels. So that is the thing what we seen yesterday. Next, after that, when it comes to H1 to H6 are 6 different heading settings. And those are valued here. The H1 is of size 2.5 rim, which is 40 pixels. 2 rim, that is for 32 pixels, 1.5 and so on. So this is the height what normally we get. We have to just check it out. We can just check it out. Fine. And next comes to description. So let me check yesterday's program. The yesterday's program is into, I think it is on my desktop. So let me go to my desktop. I go to my folder lectures, Bootstrap, and yeah, this is the para. So I'm just running. I open it. It runs in the browser. So it is saying when I change the orientation of this, that means I change to mobile view. It shows me something different. I'm not choosing iPad. I'm choosing just smart device, this Pixel 2. So this is what we get in paragraph. See, there is a paragraph. There is no top margin, but there is a bottom margin here, and that way it works. And after this, I want to just go for another example. So I just copy this, and this is what I'm seeing with description. So this is description tag. Just to identify its third, I'm using 03. I open into Notepad. These are the statements which I kept. I deleted this tag and now body is empty. So I'm replacing this body with my command. Because I'm just trying to insert a container folder which is having one heading, paragraph, and then DL. So what is DL? That is definition list. DT, that is definition term, and DD, that is definition. So I can just copy this all and just get placed into my code. I'm just trying to run this. So it is that this description 3. I open this. See, it is showing very properly. If it is not in Bootstrap, how it shows? So I remove this first code here. So I remove CSS and .js file and refresh it. See, it looks this way. Fine. So automatically margins and appearance of those fonts are standardized. So I shift it again. This is the code which you want to type it on. After this, the second program I would like to go with text colors. So when it comes to colors, there are two things. I'm having my foreground color of my text, that is text color, and I'll be having background color to my text. So it's a background color. So normally these are predefined background colors, that .pg, primary, success. When it comes to success, it's very interesting. When it comes to success, it shows some things in green. Fine, information, that is in blue. That means the things have been defined here. Let me check out with the colors and font color. So what is that? Text color and background. We'll be focusing more on background. Let's try with the same example again. So I copy paste this. I go for this as a 4. use as a background. Right click this editor and to replace this code part of it. So what I do, I choose content, and it's very important. We'll be just testing this. I'll be getting all different fonts. I'll be getting this text. I said, this is the important, this is success, this is information, this is warning. This is the display text. And that display text will be having two important classes. Please note it down. All those, both the classes, that is background primary and text white, everything is having white color. Now when I refresh, when I save this and I refresh this, see what happens. Yeah. See, all my text is having text color as what, white, because white looks very good. But there is a last color which is here. If I put white to it, it creates problem to me. See, suppose I said, I don't say dark, I say this is white, W-H-I-T, white. I save this. It will create problem for me. Just look into this, that is this part. When I refresh this, see, it's not visible, but it's there. But the color is white. So what I do, I do just make it reverse. So I have to make it what? I have to make it dark. Now after this, I just refresh this. See, it's again, it is showing gray color kind of thing. So what I have to go for blue. Now what is the command for blue? So I come here, I check it out. So what is my blue? It is blue, it's info. Fine. Yeah. So do we have info color here? We have text info also. So I can just go there and just type it on. So if I say, I don't say dark, if I say info, you only tell me what happens. I save it, refresh it, and go back into my test. I'm checking for this one. I'm just saying refresh. It has changed to blue. So you have to understand, like, these are predefined text colors and background, and this is mostly used by your thing. Fine. So this is what normally we use. After this, we are going to create table. I'm going to create next one. So next assignment is regarding table 05. It's table table. So it's that. Fine. I have to just erase the code out of that. So I edited this table. I erased the code and I insert table. See, what is the beautiful thing which happens with the table? So I go here, I enter table command. So now this is my container. And this is displaying some information in table. So when it comes to table, my table has two important things. My table has first important thing that I am having my table. My table is having some header here. And table is having some body here. In this body, I am having table ka row. In table ka row, I will be adding table ka data. But when it is the case with the table and you are having row, in heading, you have table th, that is table head. So, see, just check out how it looks and how responsive it interacts. So I am back to table. Let me check now. Yeah, this is table. I will just refresh this, so I'm showing table right. See, it looks very decent. Again, I have to just check it out. If I remove this bootstrap commands, what happens? Bootstrap is CSS and JSON files. What happens? It is a normal table. It is of no use. Fine. So it looks very, very beautiful. I'm very much impressed by this kind of table. It's very fantastic table. Just check it out. So when it comes to header, it shows some header kind of thing. It shows alternate colors up limit automatically, gray and this. How that is shown? So I come here, I say this header row 1, 2, 1, and so on. It works automatically. So how that is defined? That is defined only by few set of commands. Fine. See, what are those commands? It's very simple. I say I want to see that these are only two commands in classes. So anybody who wants to create a beautiful table like this in Bootstrap has to know only two commands. What are those? Those are very simple. You have to know table and table strip. So I remove this table and table strip and just check it out what happens. I just refresh this again. Yeah, it's a class, correct. It's class. So you see, you're getting fonts in beautiful point, but not getting it. And to identify this as a table, what I do, I just type as my class name as table, table. I save this. It is showing me as a table. But it is not having alternate selection. So what is the second part you are going to say? You are going to say table with table strip. So automatically it changes all. And that's done. So it's not very much complex. Only you have to know what command is there and for what purpose. Now there is a problem. Like if you don't know, I only taught you two commands and my part is over, I think so. But how you are going to search it out? Then you can go into this table option. See, you have to go to getbootstraps.com. Click on this table. And inside this table, you'll be getting table command is there. Then when it comes to table, there is a table class which shows this kind of table, which we have seen. It is showing very header, very bold color, very good looking. And next command is, you can set background to this. You can just set table.background, table.dark, what happens? Just check it out. So if I say table.dark, what happens? So just you have to go to say this. I remove this. I save this and refresh this. So this is dark. Fine. So this is the next command. After dark, you can go for only, you can have header as a dark. Or that can be again header as a dark. That is T header dark. What happens? I remove this because entire table dark will create problem. So I remove this, save this, and refresh this. Alright? T head, no. T head, because it, that dot indicates it's table only. Something I missed. Table light. This is the thing. I think I have to enter this into this. I wrongly entered somewhere else only. I'm just going to remove this. And this is the table head. Yeah, I have to enter class here. This is the point where we should specify the class ID. Yeah, this is, I think this is correct. I'm here, I'm just refreshing it. Yeah, it's done. Fine. After that, see, when it comes to it has anywhere dot, now that indicates that dot is class. That is head we are going to have. Stripe, I told you already. So you can have alternate things there. You can have borders to your tables also. So this is the border to the table. So this is table level command. So you have to specify into this. So it is a table level command, so I have to specify here. I save this and refresh this again. Refresh. So it is showing me border. See, slightly border has changed. Fine. Then you can have borderless also. This is borderless. Fine. Next, dark is explained to you. Over. See, yeah, it's shining this way. So it's over. Fine. And that you are going to specify into table class. It's table over. So I click this. I go to table again. Entered here. I refresh this. Just testing it. Yeah, it's working fine. For this, normally we used to write JavaScript code, and we used to check what is the entire table, it is selected or not. If selected, make it off and on and so on, and make it gray. But it is done with only one command. Definitely, there is a code which is written by some experts who are creators of Bootstrap, but we don't have to worry about it right now. So you can, again, you can create a small table also. This is a smaller table. See, what is this small table? Just try to understand. If this is the normal table, I right click on this, I say inspect. See, this is a table normally I'm getting. Fine. What is a small table? When you just check it out, what is a small table? So if you are here and if you say small table, that means if you're going to understand table, fine. You're going to understand table for smaller devices. I'm here, I have to just refresh it. See, it is a smaller table for that, for smart devices. So when you are going to use this table. Fine. For both, for PCs also and for devices also, then you go for small table. SM is small table, rest rows 1, 2, 3, that is the same thing you have to create. that's against, yeah, context classes. These are some context classes, that means color combinations can be done, which we already discussed. Fine. So this is the example. We need to just check it out. Suppose I don't want to create dark, and to make something something different color, and to go for success. That is, I think it is green. No? Success is a green color, I think so. Yeah, it's a green color. Success. Yeah, success is a green color. So I say success. I save this now and refresh it. So it has to be green color. I think I missed something. I think I have changed something, which I'm not able to identify. There's more, many times it's better you change all the effects of your table. Success, key head success. If I say dark, D-A-R-K, dark. So it does it shows dark? Yeah, it shows dark. Then it is info, I-N-F-O, info. So what if it shows? It shows info. It is not showing info. There is some problem here. I have to recheck it. So it's PG. Yeah, I think I missed BG part. So I'm recreating it. So I say it's a PG. BG success. Now just checking it out. Okay, it's done. I missed that. I missed that BG part, so it wasn't coming. Okay. So I think this is all which has been explained here regarding tables, then captions, responsive tables. See, it is having footer also. It is a responsive, horizontal, vertical responsive it is. So what are you going to say? You're just going to say dot responsive. This is that. But that is responsive to the div. That means what is the thing you're going to create? It's very simple. So you have to, this is my table, so you have to create div here first. So you should be able to close this div after this table. Then you have to be able to say the responsive, the class is responsive here, table responsive, then try to refresh it. Just go to small device first. It is automatically has been reduced to responsive. It automatically changes as per the responsiveness of the table, so it's changing. So smart device, a lot many sites are not having this responsive effect. That means they missed this very important thing, creating responsive tables. Fine. I think that's all. Rest of the things you can go into this, visit this page and just check it out. Okay. Next we'll be going for something more, that is images, in next lecture. Thank you.